Hello everybody. Today we are going to talk about the Industrial Revolution in England. This is in context of European history students, and I'm going to talk about the first part of the topic, that is the Industrial Revolution in England and the causes behind that particular revolution and why did it take place in England specifically. Throughout the lecture, we are going to go through various causes, various reasons behind why Industrial Revolution took place in England, what were the factors behind it. We're going to look at that, we're going to analyze them, and we're going to classify them under certain headings, and we're going to look at them through that lens. But before going into those details on why and how, basically why the Industrial Revolution happened in England, we need to understand that what does it mean, when did it happen, and who is the person behind the term Industrial Revolution. So for that we need to just we'll just briefly go over it. The time period of this revolution which changed the world as we know it. Today the world we know it has a major the world that we know today owes itself majorly to the Industrial Revolution of the 18th century. It changed the means of it changed the way that people functioned, the society functioned, economy functioned, and it ushered in a new age, the age of capitalism. When we divide the history, when we divide the past into various classifications or various sections, we know that we have divided the past into certain sections. We know about the earlier primitive communism, we know about slave mode of production during the Greek and the Roman Empire, Greek city-states in the Roman Empire. We know about the feudal system that followed it, and eventually the feudal system was broken down and capitalism came into being, and industry revolution was a major turning point in that shift, in that transition. And in today's world we owe today's system majorly to that one major change that took place in Europe, that started in England and then started in Britain and then spread across the European continent. So this happened in the 18th century. It started around the late 18th century in the 1760. And it continued till middle of the 19th century in England, and eventually it moved out, it spread out in the European continent. There were countries which lagged behind the changes that the Industrial Revolution brought about, but eventually the entire European continent came under its sway. But it was England which was the starting point, England which where the movement actually started and from where it spread out. So why England, and how does it change over a period of time? We'll talk about the other countries and the industrialization there in another lecture, in another talk, but today we are going to look at the Industrial Revolution in England. We know it happened in the 18th century. We know it started around 1760 in the late 18th century, and then it happened over a period of time, and the middle of the 19th century, and then it spread across the European continent. So what basically is this Industrial Revolution, and how do we what are the characteristic features? One major characteristic feature is obviously a factory type of production, where a group of workers, we know factories very well today, so but how do we define them? A factory is a place where a group of workers worked under one roof as wage laborers. So whatever labor as in the work that they put in, the energy that they put in doing a particular work or bringing about a particular work. So the workers worked as wage laborers. That means that whatever work they would do, they would get a wage in return of that. They would put in their labor, they would put in their energies, and in return of that they'll be gaining certain amount of money, certain wage. Right, so this is one of the characteristics of a proper industrialized setup, and what the kind of economic organization the Industrial Revolution brought about. the factory mode of production in which a number of people are working under one roof as wage laborers. And the second important factor is the mechanized production, where the production process is mechanized. What does that mean? That means the production process is now utilizing machines for its production instead of human efforts and human labor. So the machine is doing the production and human labor is used to work that machine. So these are the two important factors of or two important characteristics of an industrialized setup that came about after the Industrial Revolution. Who gave the term? It was Arnold Toynbee. He was a British historian and he coined this term, Industrial Revolution. We use that term very often these days, and it was he who used this term for the first time, Arnold Toynbee. And it was in a series of lectures that he delivered at Oxford from 1833, between 1883 and 1884, where he used this term for the first time, and then it started being used for the after that particular incident where he used it in the lectures at Oxford, this term started being used for defining the economic changes that came about in England in the late 18th century. So we need to remember who coined the term. It was Arnold Toynbee in 1883-84. We would now come to the various factors that were responsible for this particular economic shift or economic change. We need to understand that not one of the categories of the factors can be specifically identified or reduced to say that only this factor was responsible for Industrial Revolution. We need to understand that it was a combination of the factors that we are going to look at now. It was a combination of these factors that brought about the revolution, and that is why it is important for us to look at each of these factors specifically and understand how they influenced each other and how they influenced the actual change, actual industrial revolution that came about in the 18th century. So there are going to be a set of factors that we're going to look at to understand why industrial revolution started in England and why did it happen in England in the first place. So why England first? We're going to look at that through various set of factors. The first set of factors that historians and scholars have identified are the natural factors, and that means that England's or Britain's location, its geographical setup, its topographical setup was responsible for the for Britain being the pioneer of Industrial Revolution. They give a number of reasons for that. For example, they talk about the nearness of coal and iron mines in Britain. These mines were very near to each other, so this was useful for industrialization process, and this is why the industrialization happened in England first. Apart from that, they also talk about how there were a number of rivers that facilitated the process of transfer of goods, and transportation was a major factor which influenced the process of industrialization. And it is these geographical and natural factors of the presence of coal and iron mines near each other and the presence of a lot of rivers which facilitated the transport of goods and reduced the cost of transportation and hence helped in the process of industrialization. So this is the these are the reasons which are given under the head of natural reasons or natural factors behind the process of industrialization and why it happened in England. More convincing factors, however, are the political factors, the technological innovations, and the there are these other set of factors, the agricultural factors. So agricultural, political, and technological, we're going to look at that one by one. After having looked at the natural factors, which includes two reasons, being the rivers for fast transportation and the presence of coal and iron mines near each other, we need to come to the political factors. What was the political situation of Britain when in the 18th century, at which time the Industrial Revolution is supposed to have started? started in England. We need to understand that the glorious revolution of the 17th century, which happened in 1688, was a major turning point in the political and economic and social setup of England, because at that point of time in the glorious revolution, Catholic King James II was replaced by Protestant daughter Mary II, his Protestant daughter Mary II, and her husband William of Orange. And this transition from a Catholic system of government to a Protestant king and queen at the helm also impacted the economic fabric of England. How did it happen? What were the major features of this impact? We need to look at how this particular transition from Catholicism to Protestantism was seen as a triumph of individual liberty, because Protestants were considered to have upheld the idea of individual liberty, individual there was emphasis on individual liberty, and because of that emphasis, the commercial and the industrial classes were gaining much support, and they were gaining a lot of political favors, and the influence and the rising influence of the commercial and the industrial classes was also one of the factors behind the industrial revolution, behind the changes in the economic setup. So these commercial and the merchant class or the industrial classes were the major beneficiaries from the industrial revolution, and we need to understand that, and we need to understand the political background to that, how the glorious revolution of 1688, in which the Catholic emperor or Catholic king was replaced by Protestant king and queen, and how that particular transition was seen as a victory of liberalism, and how because of that transition from Catholicism to Protestantism gave a lot of political power to the commercial and the industrial class, and that power was reflected in the industrial revolution, the power that the commercial and the industrial class gained in the gained after the glorious revolution, that was reflected in the industrial revolution. And it is also said that the individual enterprises, and there was a promotion of individual enterprises, how individuals could come up with an idea and they would be promoted, they would be given support, they would be given capital, and that would again enhance the process of industrialization. Further, it was also established argument that the Protestant ideology was also a major reason behind the rise of capitalism, because it furthers the spirit of capitalism, because it supports individualism, it supports individual liberty, it supports property rights, and all these factors come together to help in the furthering the cause of industrial revolution, and they did so in 18th century England. They furthered the cause of industrial revolution. So these political changes, in which the beneficiaries were the industrial class, the beneficiaries were the commercial class, the beneficiaries were the people who would go ahead and support individual enterprises, who would go ahead and promote industrial setup, and all these people were gaining a lot of power, a lot of prominence because of the glorious revolution and the political changes that came about after that, and these reasons also contributed in the process of industrialization and the coming of industrial revolution in Britain. After that, we need to look at the agricultural factors. Now, in almost all the European countries that we know, agricultural production, or an enhanced agricultural production, enhanced agricultural produce contributed in the process of industrialization. In England, it happened a little early and a little fast because of the enclosure movement. We know that in England there was these movements that were happening, enclosure movement was happening from 12th century onwards, and it was in the 17th century a century before the beginning of the Industrial Revolution that these enclosure movements started happening more rapidly and more quickly. And from the time period of 1750 to 1860, a lot of enclosures occur. So what were these enclosures? We'll talk about that. These enclosures were basically a group of there were several pieces of land on which agriculture was done, on which agricultural production was done, and these pieces of land were brought together, clubbed together, and would be cultivated. After being clubbed together, they would be cultivated by a single farmer or by a single farmer with a group with the help of his workers. So this was the enclosure movement, and a result of enclosure movement were these farms with proper boundaries, proper delineated boundaries, which would be a private farm of a particular farmer. Before this, there were dispersed strips that were used for cultivation, and they were used for seasonal cultivation. There was no unified, defined boundary. There was no specific piece of land or specific farm that belonged to a particular farmer, and there were strips of land which were dispersed over a large area, and a group of farmers, a farmer cultivated a particular strip, and after the cultivation season was over, that particular strip was again used, could be used by other people as well, could be used by other farmers as well. So this was the process before the process of enclosure movement, or before the enclosures started. And the problem with those dispersed strips which were used for farming was there was that the no new innovations could be put in. There was no unified territory on which a proper large scale production could be done, and that large scale production was very important for the process of industrialization. So those things could not happen in dispersed strips. There were before the inclusion movement, there were communal fields, that means fields owned by the community and not by one individual farmer. There were pastures and lands which were not enclosed, which were not delineated, which were not specifically associated with one single farmer or one single owner. And there was a communal kind of an ownership, and during the time of cultivation, a particular strip of land was cultivated, and after that it again went into the communal use, used by the community, the larger group of people. So that was a problem, and that was a problem in the context of agricultural production. And after the enclosure movements happened, the pieces of land came together, and there was a boundary that was built around them, and that helped farmers increase productivity. Why did it help in increase productivity? Because with this, with enclosed land, the farmer can use better farming techniques. He can use more technology. He can do whatever he wants to in that farm to increase production, and he can also, do a large scale production, because a larger area could be easily cultivated by him with in that particular enclosed field. Further, another important thing that this in these enclosure movements did was, they freed many peasants from their work. So they were in a unified farm. There were less number of peasants or workers who were required to do the cultivation. And these enclosure movements freed. The workers did not have any work. The peasants did not have any work at the farm. So they were now free, and they could be easily utilized in the industrial setup, industrial production. They could be easily employed by the industrialists and who to carry out the process of industrialization. Another thing that the agricultural revolution or the agricultural productions increase did was to supply capital, because we know for the process of industrialization, the most important thing is the availability of capital, and an enclosed farm with larger productivity meant larger produce, and that larger produce was seen as a capital for the process of industrialization. So these were the influences of agricultural factors on the process of industrialization, and this is how we are going to analyze them. So enclosure movement was a very major backdrop to the process of industrialization, and we need to remember that very carefully. Further ahead, we have the role of market. So now we know that when we talk about supply and demand. We know that markets play a very major role, and industrial production is going to supply certain things, but it is going to supply them to a certain demand. There needs to be a market for those goods. And in this case, the scholars who argue that the market played a major role in the process of industrialization, these scholars argue that the markets at home and the markets overseas as in the markets away from home, away from the Britannizers, were also very important in the process of industrialization, because there was a large demand, and that large demand could not be sufficiently fulfilled or could not be catered to if a large scale production of industrial nature was not undertaken. And it was because of this demand that was there from various markets, from the internal home market of Britain and also from overseas market, that the industrialization or industrial production started, because there was a demand and there was a need for large-scale production, and that need then facilitated the process of industrialization. So the scholars who argue on those fronts argue using the need and the demand of product that was there, that and that demand facilitated the process of industrialization. And there were, why were there new markets? The new markets were there because of the geographical discoveries that were taking place after Enlightenment and after Renaissance. So there were new lands which were being discovered, new areas which were being conquered by the British powers and British power, and those conquests and those expansion and those discoveries brought into focus new markets, and those new markets include those new markets plus the markets at home produce a demand which could only be supplied with the help of proper large scale industrial production. So this argument, in which the role of market is also seen as a factor for increased for a factor can be seen as a factor of industrial revolution. Apart from that, the transport revolution, the development of proper well developed transport system in England, is also seen as a factor. In the 18th century itself, focused and very concentrated road building efforts that were being taken, and there were certain parliamentary acts in the second half of the 18th century that enhanced or that facilitated the process of road building in England, and those well built roads facilitated or hastened or they sped up the process of transportation, and that fast transportation was a major contributor in the process of industrialization. And apart from the roadways, a major transportation of goods and products in England, in Britain, was done through waterways, and there were water channels that were used for transportation of bulk products. And and regarding water transportation as well, in the 1760s and through 1760s to 1790s, there were a large scale there was a process of large scale construction of canals, and those canals then contributed heavily to the fastening of the transport system, transport of goods, and those the inland navigation that was facilitated with the help of these canals contributed a lot to the process of industrialization, because they made the transport cheaper and they made the transport faster, and they thus contributed in with the help of a cheaper and a faster transport, they contributed in the process of industrialization. The road building efforts that were done in the late 18th century and the canal construction efforts that were done also around the same time, from 1760s to 1790. So these are the major factors, but one thing that we need to remember is the most important factors for the development of industrialization is the technology, the technological innovations that happened during that time. And those technological innovations contributed very majorly for in the process of industrialization and in the process of industrial revolution. And the basic background to these technological innovations was obviously the age of enlightenment, in age of Renaissance, and you know, there was a scientific spirit that was nurtured, and with that scientific spirit there was a growth of experimentation on scientific fronts that was done, and that developed much new technology that helped in the process of industrialization. We know the development of steam engine in England was a major breakthrough, and it played a major role in industrialization, and eventually there were new technologies that were developed. And in the first phase of industrialization, when we're talking about the initial phase of industrialization, we know that the technologies on two fronts, in the field of textile and in the field of mining, the textile and the mining sectors were majorly benefited from the technological developments and technological innovations, the steam engine obviously was a very major precursor to the process of industrialization. What did the steam engine do? Steam engine made possible that the entire process of production of any good could take place in a central factory. So the process could be done in a central place, in a factory, where employees could work as wage laborers on machines that would be run by steam. So the machines run by steam could be used in a centralized factory where wage workers could, you know, provide their labor, and they would, you know, thus the process of industrialization would be furthered and industrial production would be done in a very easy manner. So this was the contribution of steam engine in the process of industrialization. Apart from that, obviously the technological innovations in the field of textile industry and in the field of mining majorly were the important factors of the process of industrial revolution and industrialization in the initial phase. We will just look at some of the important factors, some of the important technological innovations in both these fields which were important in the initial phase. Regarding textile, we know that there were certain instruments that were developed, for example, flying shuttle, spinning jenny, water frame, and power loom. These were the technological innovations, the new techniques, new machines that were developed to further and to facilitate the process of textile production. Apart from the textile, in the field of mining, the process or the new technique of smelting iron with coke, which was a material that was created by heating coal. So smelting iron with iron ore with coke produced better results and produced a good quality product, higher quality product, as compared to the product that was produced by smelting iron ore with charcoal, which was done till now. These new technologies in the field of mining, in the field of development of better iron and steel products, was a major facilitator of the further process of industrialization, of the later industrial process, or later industrial development, later industrial revolution, or later industrialization process that happened. So in the initial phase, these two factors of textile and of mining sector, or you know, iron and steel production, the textile and steel production were very majorly benefited, and it was changes in these sectors that had a major role to play in the process of industrialization, in the process of industrial revolution. So we need to look at these factors, we need to understand how these factors contributed in the process of industrialization. We need to understand that it was a combination of these factors that had eventually brought about the process of industrialization, and we need to know that of these factors, the agricultural and the technological factors had a major role to play. We'll just revise through what were the factors that we talked about, and then we'll conclude this lecture. The first set of factors that we talked about were the natural factors, in which the geographical location, the availability of water transportation, and the close proximity of coal and iron mines in the landscape of Britain was seen as a major contributor to the process of industrialization happening in England, happening in Britain. Apart from that, there were political factors, the rise of Protestant monarchs and their contribution and their, you know, their support to the industrial class and the Protestant ideals and their support to the capitalistic development, and how these political factors benefited the process of industrialization. We looked at that. Apart from that, there were agricultural factors in which the enclosure movement, in which a large piece of land was brought together and was cultivated under one farmer, which increased productivity, was a major contributor to the process of industrialization. There was also with this increased production, there was increased availability of capital for the industrial development. There was also a free there was also a set of laborers who were made free because of enclosure movements, and those laborers were easily available to be employed in industries which were developing. So these were the agricultural factors. Apart from the agricultural factors, some scholars have highlighted the role of markets in the process of industrialization, where the overseas markets, which had been newly discovered or which have been newly conquered, and the in home market of Britain were seen, as you know, having a lot of demand which could only be fulfilled with a proper large scale industrial production. Apart from that, the role of transportation, in which the road building activity and the canal construction activity of the late 18th century was seen as a major facilitator of the process of industrialization that happened in the late 18th century in Britain. Further, the technological innovations, which were the backbone of industrial revolution, were seen, and of them the technological innovation of the development of steam engine, which made possible the development of factories, and further the technological developments in the field of textile industry and in the field of mining and iron and steel industry was also seen, was also looked at as a major contributor or as a major factor for the, you know, ushering of industrial revolution in England. And these factors also inform us about why did the industrial revolution first started in England. So these are the things that we need to understand for now regarding the industrial revolution. Thank you so much.